Hi, welcome back to Hostbox CS channel and back to programming C programming tutorial. So the previous session I explained and discussed about the what is C programming, what is programming and why we need, what are the applications of C programming and the syllabus discussion, because this is the exclusive tutorial who want to learn programming properly, because you know C is the mother of all programming languages. So you know, have idea about what is machine language and why you need, why everything. I explained with the diagram also, what is interface and what is programming language and so on, what is C programming and so on. Why is so important today, and today is in the place of fourth place according to IT industry. If you want a developer, you need, you must have knowledge of C programming. If you know C programming, then you can easily catch and improve the knowledge within the from area of C++, Java, Python and so on. Let's go for session today. Today's session we are going to see the features and how to install C programming once you want to developer, and the basic structure of C programming. Let's go for session today. So I go to another mode where you will get clarity better. So it's a C programming. Have 8 features. We are going to discuss 8 features. If you want, you can write a pen and paper and pen, write it. And I'm not saying all the points here. That means I'm not denoting all the writing the points here. We can say the C programming why features, like first point is why means, because why so important and familiar means it support the high level language. High level in the sense here, it support the by default support the machine independent and also help to develop the system applications like kernel and driver and so on. Then we can say it follows structure language. We are saying structure language because generally C enables a program to convenient and always follow the structures where easy to follow. And here the structure of the program where also use the concept of functions, and also the function will reduce the program complexity and also allow the reusable. That's what in the C program we say this is the structure language and the middle language, as well as you can say high level programming language. Then we can say it's a rich library. Why? Because it have a lot of built-in library functions. It's sufficient to develop any kind of applications and extensible. We are saying extensible because the C programming will allow for the upgrades. If you want to, it always enable the it also opens the concept of upgrade. Whenever you want, you can upgrade the C programming version by default. You can just reinstall and do it. Then recursion. Recursion, what is recursion here? Recursion is nothing but a function call itself. This is a concept where when you go deeply the syllabus, you can discuss. So recursion will help you to helpful to understand better way, and also having back concept of backtracking. And remember, recursion means what? A function call itself definitely reduce the number of codings here. Suppose we have program written with 20 lines. If you use a recursion, we can complete the same program within the 8 or 12 lines and so on. Then we can say this is the one where support pointers. What is pointer? A pointer is nothing but a variable which is used to store the address of another variable. Let's go for deeply later. The pointer, what is a pointer in C program? Because it enables user to directly interact with the memory, physical memory with the computer, and also faster. Remember, so whenever go C programming, no need delay anything. If you have a programming, what happen, you can compile the program as well as execute the program fast, whether it's a small program or big program. Let's go for session. You can understand step by step, you can execute, compile the program. If no error, you can execute as soon as possible. At last, it support the memory management. By default, you know the C programming having malloc and deloc functions where it allocate or deallocate the memory dynamically. That means runtime, it make freedom of the memory space also. So these are the features of C programming: high level language, rich library, extensible, recursion, structured language, pointer and faster, at last memory management. Like that, many features available for the C programming. Let's back to PPT and continue the installation. So installation the one so simple and easy. There are many ways is there. So generally many are using today Turbo C only based on the version. So method one, either you can use install dev plus C++1. You can type in the Google, and their OUV means because it's a integrated development environment ID for the programming in C and C++. Not only C, if you want to run the C++ also you can do. Another method is install Turbo C++, where you can download Turbo C++ and how to use means you can, there will be icon will come and open the one and the screenshot look like this. See. After opening, can start the program into my what main or whatever there and compile Alt plus F9, or else you can press Alt plus F9 or compile button. Compile the icon, then you can go for Alt plus F9, and after that you can for execute the program. So Ctrl plus F9. So or else another simple method is, you don't want any software to installation, you can use the online compiler. I'm trying to use the online tutorial point or whatever there. Instantly you can just write the program and execute it. And if any errors there, it will show it compilation error. If not there, you can run the program and see the output successfully. It will say program executed success like that. So either you can do, and moreover, one more is a code block. Green is anyone, but indicator environment you can, but concept is same. C programming basics are same. Even you can execute the C programming Linux also. Now let's go for the basic structure of C programs. Very very important. If you are back, if you see programming paper in your university or some exam, university or degree courses, definitely the question asked from area. The structure of C consists of six parts: documentation section, link section, definition section, global declaration, and main at last program section. Here this is the main, and this main function is very very important, where consists of two parts: declaration and execution. Let's see the one by one with example. So here document section, here the section where it's a part of the program where the programmer gives the details associated with the program, and also he or she usually gives the name of the program, the details of the author, and other details like example you can say the file name, it start with the commands slash asterisk symbol and close with the asterisk symbol, you can write file name. What are the purpose of the program? Hello world.c or addition.c and so on. And also this documentation section is not mandatory. If your program beginning of the tutorial of the C program, just you can write what is the purpose of the program, what purpose, factorial means factorial.c or addition.c and so on. If you want, you can mention with these commands, otherwise not required. Then link section, this is the one, this is a part of the code where used to declare all the header files that will be used in the program, and also it leads to the compiler being told to link the header file to the system libraries. This is a main important one. Whenever you write the C program in any IDE, as a code block or Dev++, suppose if you have to write the program, start with the link section, that is hash include stdio.h. This is the header file, or we can say header file as a pre-processed directive. So the upcoming session we will detailedly discuss about this one. Remember, if you want to write any program, you have to start with the hash include stdio.h. Then another one is definition section, where in this section we are, you can define different constants. The keyword define is used to in this part. Is not also not, this is also not mandatory. For example, if you want to find the area of the circle, you can define has defined PA is equal to 3.14 and like that. Or else you can has defined A is equal to 20. That means what? The whenever call the A value be 20 only. Like that. Then global declaration. Here, this is a part of the code where, and link section, you have to remember, sorry, the link section, what is that one? It will header file, it will support a header file, where header file have two functions called library function or predefined function, and one more is a user defined functions. So you predefined function, you can say example printf scanf. For example, in your developing the program, where instead of printf, if you give print, what will happen? It will say error, link, it will say link error and so on. Remember. Then global declaration, here where we can say the example, here all the global variable used are declared in this part. Here the user defined functions are declared in this part of the code. Example, you can say float area float r int a is equal to 7. You can write any one example. So global declaration, the one we remember, you know, in the C program variables are divided in two parts. One is the local variable and the global variable. Local variable means in the program you can example int a is equal to 10, you can use in the particular place only. But global variables, what we can assign in the, we can initialize a variable. For example, initializing a is equal to 20, the value, the a is equal to 20 will be used in the any of the program, not only main program, and sub functions supported programs I can use. Int a is equal to 20 means whenever want you can use the global variable. Local variable not possible. Global declaration, if you give int a is equal to 20 or else a is equal to 20, we can use in the main program as well as the support of the sub function of the program also. Then main function. So one, every C program need to be have the main function. Each my main function and two part, that is called declaration part and executable parts. How do you start a program? If you want to start the C program, you start with the pre-processed directive or header file. After that, you have to start with the main function, int main, or we can say void main. And open brace, let's see the structure here. And why we need declaration part? Because the declaration part is the one where all the variables are declared. Then execution part begins with the curly brackets,
and ends with a curly close bracket. Both the declaration and execution are part inside the curly process. Remember, this is an example program where int main or void main, open brace, int s code 10, print the value of a, I am giving it percentage d comma a and return 0 and close bracket. Sorry for the inconvenience, I have to give the close bracket. So whenever write the program, you should be at the close bracket, open bracket and the close bracket. Okay, this is the points about main function, and another one is what? Subprogram. So subprogram function one, where these are all come under the category of user defined functions. Here for example, you can say int add of int a comma int b, then open brace and return a plus b and so on. The meaning is you can do add the two functions, that is variables a and b. Upcoming sessions we will go and discuss later. And remember about the program, any program you want to start, you have to remember about this main, int main or void main with open bracket, close bracket, then open brace and close bracket, floor brackets, curly brackets. If not, the program's error. You can start, declare and execute the program, any program. After that, if you want, you can install the, you can use the, you can add the sub program function. The or user defined function is not mandatory. Based on our regression or whenever come deeply user defined function, you can use or based on the task. So remember here, so you know what are the features of C language and how to install easily. The structure of C concept 2, 6 pass documentation is not mandatory, and link section and definition section, global declaration, main function, at last sub program function. Okay, these are the basic structure of C programming. The upcoming sessions we detail discuss token, data types and so on. And after going to tokens, data types, you can go how to write a first C program and execute and so on. So if you have any queries or suggestions, please communicate in the social media like Twitter and Facebook. And please like, share and comment and subscribe and press bell icon for more updates. Thanks for watching.